Welcome back guys, this is Vishu from SavageCamp and this is going to be another video on file reading and writing. So, in your Python scripting, you will often encounter times where you have to read a HTTP log file or a web page or an application file and extract some data out of it. So, in the last video, we learned how to write into files. We also covered how to read a file. So, now let's do something practical. Before reading any file, I want to go over one method of list that we did not cover in the previous lectures, which is the join method. So, if I take a variable name is equal to if I print name, this is going to give me this long sentence. So let's split name and we will save it in a variable A. So if I do A now, you will see a long list. What happens if I want to convert this list back into string? So what I will do is use the join method. So the way to use a list join is you put two quotes, because strings are always denoted in between quotes. So we will put this and let's do a space, because we split according to space. So we will put a space over here and I will say dot join and I will pass the list. So I will do A. So this brought back this list and this is how you use the join method. But what if you put something else in instead of the space? What if I put no space? If I do that, it will just add everything in without any spaces because we did not specify any spaces. So you can see that whatever we put between quotes is how it is joining the list. So if I literally put dollar signs and do a dot join A, it is going to put a dollar sign between each of these elements and join them. So again, I'll take this and I will add a space and space and you will see the spaces being added. So whatever you put, it is going to join every element of the list using that. So let's do this and you will see it join the list with this. So the reason I told you this is because we have a log file over here and this log file has a structure. It has date, it has time, it has what happened in the log. So there's error, warning, whatever the message is, and then there is a username. What we are going to do is very simple. We are going to take the date, we are going to take the time, we are going to take the log message and we are going to take the username. So how are we going to do this? So let's do f is equal to open and I'm going to open input.txt with reading mode. Let me close this so I don't forget it. So now I'll do for line in f, I will print out the line. So if I run this, you will see that after every line, there is a blank line. I don't want this. So what I will try is line.strip to remove the slash n at the end of each lines. Each of these lines have a slash n. That is why it is coming in the next line. So if I run this now, you will see it's pretty similar to what we saw over here. So I will save this as line strip is equal to this. And now let's do print line strip dot split and let's keep it simple and split it with the spaces. So I will split this with spaces. So what happens now? So you will see we have a list. And we have list of elements and we have first three elements. We have the date, we have the time, we have the log message and the last element is the username. So what I can do is date is equal to, what we can do is use this dot split method at the end of this. So I'm going to strip this line and then also split it. So if I do this, it's going to give me the same thing. So here I have the whole thing in line strip. So I will do date is equal to line strip. Instead of dot, let's do zero. And time is equal to line strip of one. And what I can do here is print date and comma time. So if I print date and time, it should give me the date and time of the file. Now I know the next element is going to be the third one, which is the log message. So message is going to be line strip of 2, and I can have message over here, and I can see the messages. And the last one is user, and the user is the last element in here. So I will do user is equal to line strip of minus 1 to get the last element. And if I do user, you can see the user is over here. So that is how you read a log file and then get data out of it. So you have what some user did, and we can rearrange this. So we can do printf, then we can do error is equal to error, and not error, message, and then add date and time. So just formatting the output, and you can have a readable output from the log file about what happened. So you have the username, he had the error of this at this time. So that is it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, because it's pretty fun reading the log files and getting out the data. It's always challenging. It would never be this easy, because there would be IP addresses, there would be various strings. So don't think that this is all. You will get a lot of different varieties, but this is really good if you're a beginner. So I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you guys in the next video.